The champagne is still on the ice for the Uganda Cranes, whose 1-1 draw with Zimbabwe has left them with 4 points out of a possible six. Emma Okwi's 12-minute tap-in was cancelled by Kama Bilia's incisive finish shortly before the break.
We can see Uganda on the attack. The shot's coming in. Oh, it's at the back of the net. They've scored it. Okwi. Okwi of Sibir SC has put Uganda ahead. And that was just a moment of pure brilliance. See, they've split open this Ugandan defence. Can they get the ball across? Oh, it's at the back of the net. Billiard!
It's not just the celebrations that were put on hold. Cranes coach Sebastian De Sabri has admitted that there is work to be done if Cranes are not only to finish the group stage with a flourish, but also show that they belong in the last 16.
It was a difficult game for us. So we scored in first, and after the our goals, I think we not accept the pressure of this game.
It increasingly looks like it will take something apocalyptic for the Uganda Cranes not to reach the last 16. They have a late outstanding double save from goalkeeper Dennis Onyango to thank. The Cranes skipper pulled a rabbit out of the hat to keep out Ivan Zruski's shot.
The competition is a little bit tough, but we take game by game. Every team comes with its own challenges, and the more we fight, the more we win, the more we get confidence going forward.
Swedish-based defender Ronald Muchibi had a shaky display in defence, sitting in for Murshid Juko. He, however, believes better days are ahead, as does striker Patrick Kadu.
No, obviously, you know, it's tough when you play with new players. Takes time to play, you know, to make everything work, because this was our first competitive game together.
A point was well deserved in our game. I thank the players for the commitment, that unity.
The top two nations in each of the six groups advance, along with the four best third-placed countries. Felix Manyindo, NTV Sport.